Here's what we know as facts. And if anything that I'm about to say is not a fact, tell me. Is it or is it not true that James Comey was warned at least three specific times, he and all the upper echelon of the DOJ and FBI, that Christopher Steele's document dossier was unverified, that Hillary paid for it, and that he had a political agenda? I know of three times. My sources say there may be as many as five times.
And Sean, remember who told him that? Wasn't anybody. It was Bruce Orr conveyed to the FBI that this guy you're getting information from, the guy I'm meeting with, this Christopher Steele guy, he's got real problems. He's got a deep bias against the president, so much so that he said he was desperate for Trump not to win. So, yeah, of course they were on notice of that fact.
Okay. Is it also true, according to the Nunes report, the Grassley-Graham memo, that the bulk of information in the FISA application was the unverified, Hillary bought and paid for, dirty Russian dossier that finally the New York Times acknowledges was likely Russian misinformation from the get-go, or disinformation?
Yes.
The bulk of evidence.
They
all right.
led with it. They
and
led
isn't
with
it. That's a fact, correct? That's not. This is now on the record, incontrovertible. There's no ambiguity. All right, next question. Is it also true the former deputy FBI director McCabe said without the dirty Russian dossier, the Russian disinformation from the get-go, there would be no FISA warrant issued to Carter Page, which backdoored the spying into all things Trump campaign, transition, and presidency?
Yes, but for the dossier, they don't get the warrant. That was buttressed by another employee at the Justice Department who said it was a 50-50 call if we could get it without the dossier. So, yes, and it was reinforced by another person at the FBI as well.
Was there ever an attempt before this October 2016 dossier to get or FISA application to get a similar warrant on Carter Page?
That I don't know. What I do know is two American citizens associated with the presidential campaign were spied on by our FBI. And the one we're talking about, the dossier, was the basis to go get that warrant to spy on Carter Page.
And Horowitz yesterday, as I look at all of this, seemingly agrees that Comey tried to deceive President-elect Trump during the now infamous 2017 meeting at Trump Tower when he was president-elect by saying the dossier was salacious but unverified, the opposite of what he said in October 2016. And then when he renewed the FISA application and signed three of the four.
Yeah, well, right. Witnesses interviewed by the OIG, by the Inspector General, discussed Trump's potential responses at that meeting to being told about the salacious dossier, including, this is important language, including that Trump might make statements about or provide information of value to the pending Russia interference investigation. So they go up there to that meeting, and they're trying to set up the president, get information from the president about an investigation, while they're telling the president, you're not under investigation. That's from the head of the FBI. No wonder Jim Comey did a referral on this guy.
So while he was telling the president-elect in January of 2017, after he signed a FISA application, using the dirty dossier as the bulk of information, no dossier, no FISA warrant, that telling the president-elect that he was not the subject of an investigation and saying it was unverified, the opposite of what he testified both before in his application for FISA warrant. He signed a warrant that said it was verified. Then he talks to Trump and says it's unverified. Then he signs a renewal application twice that says it's verified, correct?
That's right.
So Jim Comey is a liar.
Well, but Sean, Jim Comey is the guy responsible for what our country has had to live through now for over 2 years. Think about it. He's the guy who starts the investigation in July 2016. He's the guy who puts Peter Strzok in charge, the guy who is out to stop Trump. He said that in a text message. He's the guy who, as you just described, allowed the dossier to be used to get a warrant to spy on a fellow American citizen. He's the guy who leaks the memos to get Bob Mueller appointed special counsel. And now this important thing, he's the guy who goes up there to Trump Tower on January 6th and tries to trap the president. And we know he's trying to trap him because witnesses said so, and Michael Horowitz reported it. And when Jim Comey leaves that meeting, he walks right out, gets in the car, and immediately starts typing, memorializing the conversation with the president-elect of the United States so that they have that information right then on a secure laptop. This guy, Jim Comey, it's no wonder Michael Horowitz said and referred him to the Justice Department for prosecution.
All right, now let's talk about what we think the outcome of all of this is. What do you think the outcome is? Where, in other words, Jim Comey's dodged a bullet twice here. Does he get away with what we now have established as premeditated, he was warned, fraud on a court, because we now know the dossier was unverifiable? And when the FBI finally checked themselves, what did they find out? They said the same exact thing, didn't they? They said that, no, we can prove 90%+ of this isn't true, which means none of it was true.
Yeah,
correct?
So look, you know that Bill Barr has tasked John Durham to look into all this. All I know is this. Michael Horowitz has done an outstanding job in every single report we've received from him. Michael Horowitz gave the same referral for Jim Comey that last year he gave for Andy McCabe. We know what's happening with Andy McCabe. We will see what happens ultimately with Jim Comey. We got two more reports coming. We got the report coming from Mr. Horowitz on the broader FISA issue, which we've talked about here some. And then, of course, we have the final investigation that's being done by John Durham, U.S. Attorney from Connecticut, at the request of Attorney General Bill Barr. So we will have to see. All I know is the good work Horowitz has done, and he gave the exact same referral for Jim Comey that last year he gave on his report about the Clinton investigation that he gave for Andy McCabe. So we'll have to wait and see.
All right. So we're going to get this report. Now, I understand it's complete. Tell me the process. And are you as concerned as I am that the FBI director now, Ray, has shown no interest, seemingly, to clean up the greatest, the best, the premier law enforcement agency in the entire world? Why?
Well, look, I have confidence in Bill Barr. And Bill Barr is the attorney general. Bill Barr runs the Justice Department. And Bill Barr has indicated he's going to get to the bottom of this. Bill Barr says he wants to err on the side of transparency when it comes to what's classified, what isn't. So Mr. Horowitz has given the report to the attorney general. They're going through the classification process and the declassification process. We will see what we ultimately get. I think we just have to, unfortunately, and I know this is taking a long time, this whole thing. We just got to let this process play out. But the attorney general wants to get this information to the American people as quickly as he possibly can, and he wants to do it in the most transparent fashion that he possibly can as well.
All right. Let's talk now about what the next steps in all of this are. How do you see this unfolding? And everyone keeps asking me, well, when is we going to see something? When is this going to come out? When is this going to happen? You know, do you really believe, Jim Jordan, that they are going to hold their own to the same standards that you and I would be held at?
I do. I mean, like I said, I've been very impressed with the work of the attorney general. I'll tell you what I am concerned about, though, Sean. I'm concerned about the fact that the Democrat chairman of the respective committees that have jurisdiction, the Oversight Committee and the Judiciary Committee, they don't even want to have a hearing on this. Because remember, mm-hmm. the legislative branch, we can't put anyone in jail. All we can do is get the truth out for you and the media and those across the country, the American people. If they don't go, they're not going to have hearings so we can ask the questions. I actually think Mr. Horowitz is sort of surprised that no one has contacted him from the chairman's offices about his report from 3 weeks ago on Mr. Comey and the leaks issue. Because I've asked Mr. Nadler in open hearings, and his response to me is, I don't know, I haven't thought about that. Because Mr. Nadler is too busy focused on throwing subpoenas on Corey Lewandowski and trying to impeach the President of the United States. He can't do the work.
At what point, Jim Jordan, does somebody say that this is nothing but harassment? In other words, Corey's been before the committee twice, before the Senate committee, 15 hours before Mueller. You know, if he gets one little, you know, they're already talking about holding him in contempt. And I'm thinking, why would you even ever say another word to these people? Because it's a perjury trap. And if you say one itsy-bitsy thing that is not the same as what you said in any of the other 400 hours you testified, they're going to claim perjury, perjury. Why would anyone testify? I think everybody should plead the fifth.
No, you're right. I will tell you though, I thought Corey did an outstanding job in front of the committee earlier this week.
He did. Now then, because they embarrassed him, now they want to drag him back and say, oh, this was contempt of Congress or something. They're just dying to nail this guy for showing up and talking to them.
No, you're right, and that the contempt idea is just ridiculous. And look, he tested, like you said, hours and hours on four different occasions.
This is
and
now
he was
harassment.
Willing to come in voluntarily for this too, and he was willing to come in voluntarily in front of the committee, and they just said, nope, we're going to hit with a subpoena anyway. So that is unfortunately just how Mr. Nadler is operating this committee. And this
it's just like if they would have told Paul Manafort's lawyer or Roger Stone's lawyer, hey, can you have your guy surrender at X time at X place? They would have been there. Yeah,
of course. Of course they would have.
All right, Jim Jordan, we're hoping to get this information sooner than later.